with the right amount of focus and AA there, they could put him down.
And Alchemist.
Big bad Alchemist.
What an interesting pick.
Much easier, because during a team fight, he generally has a ton of regen and Ice Blast says no to all of that.
Early days here, but IG off to a good start. So you see Miracle starting to get back in the game as bottom lane, the action heating up. Mind Control slowed down, not quite enough for the Cold Feet to take.
Uh-oh.
It was almost there.
Uh-oh.
He sticks around, he's heading up. He wants the solo kill, but not gonna happen. Q scores a crucial first blood for IG. And that is the game of Bristlebagger, as there's quite a few heroes that can take advantage. The Alchemist, the Bristleback, potentially Batrider, lots of Flash Farmers in this game as 6S continues to apply pressure top. Traditionally, Weaver, one of the stronger laners to try and deal with the Batrider, and he's going to make his move. But Tumba Man going in deep for a potential solo kill as the Swarm takes him down. That minus armor is substantial. He's low, sticking up, but right into the clutches of GH. Liquid looking to strike back here. Sakuchi, and they will get the kill. A long committed chase does the trick, but at the same time, IG able to grab a kill of their own bottom. They take down Mind Control again, and
Batrider vision, and of course the Wolves will be coming out to just scout everywhere. To me, this is one team with like global satellites,
Mind
Optics, and then Mind Control is playing blind on this bottom lane.
Double
Boboka.
Damage rune, but Boboka chewing through him. Those spines don't phase him. Cold Feet not going to set in. The Quills are stacking up, but the DD rune gets the job done as Boboka continues to rampage through Liquid. This goes back to that IO ban where the
Curl Tusk gonna contribute in the mid game. I'm not sure.
Yeah, historically when we've seen Curl on the Tusk, find those early kills, but watch out mid lane, Miracle. Faboka's got your number, trying to slow him down with the Cold Feet coming in. They'll TP in, but it's a measly Visage. What can he do here? GH down, or sorry, a Miracle down. GH trying to respond with Batumba Man joining the fray. Chases on with Sakuchi. But Provoka's away to safety. They force out multiple TPs.
Unable to get it. Like you mentioned, XSS getting the freedom to catch up on the farm. I'm not gonna lie, LD. Ooh, so we have a roll in.
Big roll on the Q. They want to catch him out here. The shards come through. The Sunstrike. Will it connect with the Cold Snap? Miracle.
Magic wand.
He turns around.
All right. Just a quick 360. It will take him down in the end.
Good catch on the Ancient Apparition. Alchemist in the jungle gives up the lane to the AA and good critical pickoff to prevent that level 6. Meanwhile, simultaneously, we see Mantumba Man chasing down. Liquid showing some sign of hope here.
Don't really want to run into this team without a BKB. So I like the Necro Bulk pickup a lot. It allows him to keep his hero a bit safer and still apply pressure. As Liquid move in, they want to go on this bottom lane. They're going to commit forward onto Q, catching out the Ancient Apparition. One more attack scores the kill. A very successful daytime here for Liquid, and all the while, Miracle trying to play catch up in the mid lane, but this Alchemist is far ahead. 7k net worth, almost halfway to the Relic as XXS gives GH pursuit. Diving deep behind this top tower, there will be a rotation from Pearl, but in addition to that, the Big Bad Wolf
is coming
in hot and heavy. He wants GH, looking to munch him up.
Nice.
Snowball keeps him alive, Miracle joins the fray. Bernie can do naught but watch and now commits the familiar summon. Jukes away. So far, not too shabby for Liquid.
Uh-oh, this Wolf is somewhat confused. He's where'd I go? Just runs around the corner, still maintaining that really high movement. Will just fall very, very quickly. Looks like he's working into a hood.
Aggressive Lumi. They're already going to this tower. They're doing it at nighttime. They're doing it with the Bristle. It's not particularly farmed in front. But here come the familiars. Batumba Man getting onto Q. The Swarm not going to connect. Don't know if he actually needs it. Stun number one. Stun number two. If there were any questions about GH's versatility, well, they're getting answered now. This tier one now well under siege. But Bernie continuing to pressure at the tier two top. Curl wants to make a move. He could be getting trapped.
Nice stalker on the back line, though.
In too, looking for the flank. Revs up the snowball, then tries to retreat. The shards are there, but not going to keep burning away because he's running in. Munches up the tusk. The snow cone for dessert. And bottom lane, XXS being pressured here. Batrider almost down. Miracle pumps the damage in. Scores the kill. And the tower denied top. Still Liquid losing more and more map control. But they are responding well in terms of kills. There is absolutely no way Liquid should have the vision advantage unless they win multiple fights, get a gem. It's expensive even to invest in that. And here comes the Blink debut. They cut off the back, but he comes back with a vengeance on the mid lane, pushing Mind Control in. Controlling him nicely. IG score the kill. Can they transition for an objective? Lumi, they want
to
try.
To roll.
Straight to the pit. No hesitation from IG.
Man, and flame the agent.
Fighting into this is so hard, right? The Radiance is up. That mischance is going to be absolutely huge against all this physical damage. So Liquid just don't want to risk it in a 4v5. So you don't have Avenge, you don't have the GH. You know, Earthshaker or Io, both of which are fantastic defensively, in particular for interrupting that top initiation. As the move happens in the top lane, they look for mind control, trying to deal with him, and he will be shut down again. That is death number 5 for the Bristleback. He is just not a factor this game.
IG going for a smoke gank. They have the vision right on this ramp. They can go for the GH for the quick kill if they want. I think they're seeking for a bigger kill.
They see Miracle. This is the hero that needs to farm. He can't afford to die, but he's at the neutral. And Miracle trapped out. No mercy from the Vigilante bat. He'll take him down again.
And this Ward is just seeing so much curl now is detected. He's only level 5. His raindrop is not going to save him as he's being burned off. Okay, nice snowball here. Alchemist is going to stun himself, but there's just way too many heroes. Curl will also go down. 5k network lead here, 17 minutes in. And just for a second, take a look at that network bar on Alchemist. It is ginormous. They have a lineup that needs a ton of items to operate. You know, Miracle Invoker takes a while to get online. I think the adjustment is going for those Lincoln spheres that the panel has mentioned. Miracle is going for it right now. Weaver, I think, needs to go for one as well. You just need to make sure that you're surviving against these Batrider Lassos. Miracle, though, Sunstrike kill, I believe, in the base.
Yeah, almost killed one off Matumba Man solo and catches Boboka on the TP out. Sick play, and now
okay,
looking for
OP.
He does have Aegis here. They'll have to kill him twice or get out, and they do. Kill him once, look for more. Mind Control joining the fray, but has to be careful. Look for the familiar Sun, trying to lock OP down, but the Ice Blast is there. Connecting on two, blast him back in with the play break. XXS, oh, OP, he even finds Matumba. Ends the killing spree, but the combo comes through. Miracle roasting up the wolves and donning his hide as a prize. Three do fall for Liquid and punish it with the vision game and with pickoff. So it's not just split push without a follow-up, it's split push with a purpose.
Yes. Currently
looking for the jump on the mid lane again. It's XXS, and he catches the save. Kuro, no escape. Silent stuff dealt with early. Good familiar stuns by GH. But still, the chase is on. Can they follow this up with another tower? They look for more. Pounding GH from the side. XXS blinks in. The swarm descends, and IG keep the ball rolling. Multiple kills at nighttime.
Constantly providing vision, speaking of which, Matumba Man thinks he's safe, thinks he's farming, and the gank is coming.
Well, you wanted a Lincoln Sphere for him. The lasso is still cooling down,
okay,
so he needs to get up the silence or time lapse out, but it's on cooldown. Play break back in, with the silence coming through, the cold feet, ice blast! The bug is squashed. IG making it look easy versus Liquid. Shoving in this middle lane, looking for the tier 2. But here comes Liquid on the wraparound. Mind control, stacking up the quills. OP's the man in front. They want to find something a bit tastier on the backside. So they sneak around. They try to get the jump on IG, but that's damn hard when they can fly. The bat jukes away, and OP rushes in straight onto the bristle. Nails him with the ice blast and to his cross, where he dies. Now looking on the other side of the fight for Miracle, they take him down too. IG completely overrunning Liquid, and now
this could be Rex right here.
Might even be
60
more.
Seconds
no
before Miracle
backs.
Comes back. What are they going to do against
they
this?
They can go good stall though by GH with the familiar stun, but they keep on smacking here. Melee Rex dropping. Will go down. Familiar's being farmed up. Still no Invoker. 25 seconds without Miracle. But IG, content with their one lane advantage, won't push it further. I think IG definitely watched that replay. You saw their second stage bans were very targeted, but hold that thought, because IG, they know this game isn't over yet. They want to secure the victory.
Snowball.
The snowball, good retaliation from Kuro, but now he's being controlled by the Night Stalker. Boboka's in through the rear, the Ice Blast comes through. Another connection with the Flame Break. That teamwork making the dream work for IG.
Okay.
They will shatter too, and now again, continuing pursuit, Liquid will keep the Invoker alive, and Matumba Man hanging on by a thread, but the chase is on. If they can keep the vision, Matumba's in
yes,
trouble.
Yes, they can.
No time lapse. Lock him down and finish him off. IG putting a bow on it here, and now Shrines on the menu. This ward, Lumi. This ward going to make life very difficult for Liquid. IG in perfect formation here to anticipate this Liquid expedition. Kuro leads it fully forward, and the smoke is revealed by the least gankable hero on the team. They're going to try anyway. OP does get locked down by the shards. He actually gets pushed away from his team about as good as it gets, but they can't focus him down. He just waltzes away. All the while, the rest of IG weren't really doing anything, but now they make their move. Lasso, Ice Blast, connecting on two, and in a song of ice and fire, Liquid are overrun. Kuro gets brought down. Three hit the deck. Now back for mind control, turning him into Chop Suey. They will kill him off. Chat wheel being spammed, and now Roche is next. IG putting on a clinic here to open up this TI.
Always have some mega push. Yeah, sure, you got Visage, you got that Invoker, but I don't think it's enough push, at least not the same standard as Team Liquid showed.
As a result, they've been able to punish with the bad pick. So IG move in, looking for the flank is Batumba Man, but already the base is in shambles, two lanes down. From bad to worse for Liquid. Burning looking to join the squad. Assault Karass completed for him. He has been the siege engine to back up the Alchemist as the frontline tank. Now the Shiva's coming out and gets aggressive. Charging in, lobbing in the stun, going for GH. Even through the pipe, the damage is substantial. They try to slay the beast, but the Alchemist shrugs it off, forcing Liquid on their heels, chewing through the Bristle's HP. I'm the real tank now, says OP. This is not your Bristleback of 3 to 6 months ago. GH now taking the stun again and Burning racing onto him. They turn back for mind control. Miracle sounds the retreat with the deafening blast, but Kuro is caught in the crossfire. A second hero down, the support duo of Liquid that has been so instrumental in their run to first place in the groups.
They had no role in the early game. They had no good lanes to gank. They weren't able to win their own individual lanes when they weren't ganking. They weren't stacking like you were mentioning. I just felt the effectiveness wasn't there, and Boboka spamming them Jayos as IG about to take Mega Creeps.
Boboka showing that he is not just a Monkey King player. 4-2 and 15, he might overextend here, but it's okay for IG. They've already gotten the Megas. We have seen some Mega Creep comebacks, but down 30k gold. You'll probably need 4 or 5 fights to turn it, and Liquid do lose one. They'll sound the GG. IG dominant to open up TI. What more is there to say? There were a lot of question marks around this team, Lumi.
For Team Liquid, their last picks coming in now. Monkey King.
Miracle Monkey King, man. There it is.
Armor is king.
Is the Riki just purely here for the vision? Is there anything else that you could expect Boboka to get accomplished?
I think on paper, during the draft, you look at these heroes like the Ancient Apparition, the Keeper of Light, as we have a Burrow Strike happening on the bottom side. Miracle takes a couple of nukes here, and they might be able to right-click him down. XSS, though, will get iced up. One more right-click here from Q. They will get the kill.
They're gonna
and
get
here
more.
Comes Boboka. You ask what he's going to do? He's going to give you the second kill of the game for IG. They have disastrous
meanwhile, top lane, Burning gets blown up as Liquid just get off that Illuminate in time. So they answer back, but the early aggression, again going IG's way.
Kind of playing the same position. You don't have a leading disable.
Oh, mind control. Never mind, which looks like he wants to go. Actually coming back in. Does have the Chain Frost available. OP seems like he wants to fight this, but has no points in Unstable Concoction. And meanwhile, the top lane, Burning, is able to run down GH, gets the kill. Mind control looking to contest these Ancients early.
Very simple plan, but as a Ursa.
For Miracle, not for Matumba.
Oh, sorry, for Miracle, yes. He is going to be the secondary damage dealer.
Epicenter, here we go. Straight onto Miracle. Cloud's going to follow this up. A quick kill for IG. The Blink debut, a resounding success. Here comes the push.
Yeah, you just don't expect Sand King to pick up a Blink so early. And right now, Curl's hanging around. A Chain Frost to say what's up. And Kuro will just... And the reason why he's so high level, he's been maxing Sacrifice.
With that, IG's gonna kick into high gear as far as net worth goes, unless Liquid makes some moves, Lumi. The Blink on Matumba Man you wanted to see is now about to be picked up, but Mind Control getting caught out here. The Burrow to start. Can he TP out quickly? The Cloud comes through, he tries to run. Stacking up the Quills, he's gonna man fight his way out of this. Mind Control takes down one, and that's it.
Oh,
Bristle feeling very mortal in this TI.
Yeah, running for him again. Shapeshift about to end. Burning recognizes that as well. We'll just turn back. Hanamitis, though, is online.
And now wants to retreat away successfully. Matumba Man does have his Blink Dagger. TP cooling down. Can he make this committed jump forward? He can, but with the Frost Armor, it's not the easiest kill. Burning into the trees and GH in pursuit. They maul the wolf. The bear wins the duel.
Bottom, bottom lane.
Miracle caught out by a burrow. IG with the response. Radiance online.
I think that's a great trade.
Let the farm begin.
He loves to go for the mechanism. He's starting that right now. He didn't go for it last game because he was up against the AA. Look for Team Liquid to five man up and go for engagements here. Oh, Ice Flash.
They need this kill.
Trying to cut him off.
Success does get clipped, but now the Chain Frost ushering Liquid away. OP's on the chase. Matumba Man.
Invisory.
Potentially in danger here. Boboka trying to drop down that cloud and burning, revving up, shapeshift. And off to the races.
Oh,
the wolf hunting him. Mind control on the retreat. Can they isolate this bristleback? Bring him down. Good staggered retreat here, but at the same time, still the pursuit continues. Mind control getting control, but not being finished off rapidly. If Miracle gets a position, pouncing down, sprints in from behind. This chaotic fight favoring Liquid, it seems, on the second round of engagement. A one for one thus far. Committing onto mind control, but the GH save! Huge plays, Gandalf to the rescue, and now Miracle sprinting up into the trees again in a way to safety. Can they cage him?
Yes, they can.
The burrow's there, the Epi to follow.
Wait.
He sprints out, but XXS with the prediction plague! Unbelievable!
I think I just tuned into an episode of Naruto. I just see ninjas jumping everywhere following each other, and great play by XXS.
Well, the difference is that QO had farmed that game.
Right now, Miracle's like first in the line to the food bank, like for food snap. He has nothing.
This is big. Liquid do claim an Aegis, crucial for them. They grab that objective, and now they want to chase for more.
It's hunting him. He's just died twice.
Well, and the Ricky. Ricky's
yeah,
up in all
Ricky
over.
And guess where XSS is? Right next to GH, about to hunt him down again. He understands that this is a big
setting
part
up
of the push.
Bottom. Q maybe wants to go here. The Epi comes through. Connection on Miracle. Can they finish him? He manages to jump away.
One
hit from death.
Force
He's
that.
Not out of there. Just shoves himself in. And gives him the old scorpion claw. Now Boboka hunting for that follow-up. He moves on to GH, again, just continuing to shut down his farm. Force him on his heels. He does have the TP if need be, but the bait is there in the tricks of the trade. Still may go down, though. The Ice Blast setting up the timings right from Kuro. The trap has been sprung. GH staying alive, thanks to help from an old friend. Basically made up for that greed early, and now are really starting to dish out the damage. Liquid still holding the Aegis for a wee bit longer. They'd love to find a couple of follow-up kills, maybe make a play, but in the bottom lane, it's IG who gets the jump. They burrow in, commit for this Bristle. Can he stay alive? Tries to retreat with the Solar Crest, the mech. It's not enough. IG throw the kitchen sink.
And here comes Ursa.
It will clip him for now. The Frost Armor keeping Q alive. Nice follow-up there. XXS with the save. The offlane Sand King buying time, creating space. Liquid cannot reply.
Speaking of vision, Boboka has picked up a gem as well, so he's going to be able to walk around the map and give even more trouble to the Liquid supports.
Meanwhile, it's starting to feel like that's something Liquid are going to want. Oh, they do with the Lycanwolves.
They could kill Ricky.
That's a big kill for Matumba Man.
Yep. I feel like the Sand King has perhaps done that job better than he has so far.
They have 13 kills, and he has been in on 11 of them, so...
Well, hold that thought here as Matumba Man jumps in again, looks for Q, will find another solo kill, all right. But he gets Yule Scepter up.
Oh, not worth it if he dies. Matu in trouble, does manage to get off the Enrage. No more Aegis for him. He's gone in deep for this.
See,
Ice Blast coming in, but nothing to combo with it. The timing was not right for Matumba Man. Forcing it too far and costly death. Just poking, prodding, staying out in front. Matumba Man lurking on the side, wants to find the opening here. Did just have vision for a moment of XXS. Not actually hidden. Liquid, no, he's in the neighborhood. He's going to try for the epicenter, but Matumba Man's there to interrupt this initiation. Great presence of mind from him. The burrow coming through, connecting on two, but look at the heal. GA, it's the engine that keeps the push going. Now they deploy the Monkey King Wukong's command. Still, though, IG get the AA kill. They stay alive, but Boka's in through the rear. He blinks out. He will get decapitated. Liquid, like an objective.
Coming
they
in.
Cage the Alchemist,
from
though.
The back. They
like it with
coming
the S-class.
In.
Looking for more, but XXS with the rescue plays, the triple burrow. Liquid still committing. They will bring him down. This push just won't stop. Finally, Burning gets a follow-up kill. It was one buyback already for Liquid. They need this tower. They might need more. IG know its importance. They won't get it up freely. They don't want to lose their shrines. They're going to get the follow-up kill. That's a dieback. on the Ancient Apparition. Huge commitment from him to try and take this tower down, and now the chase is on. They can route them in the rear. Mind control. Oh! He gets up the quills. Matu with the assist. Can they bring the bristle down? He's also tanky, and Boboka continues pursuit, but it's slow. They need damage. They need control. He keeps on running. The wolves come in. They get him from the front, and IG
needs
will
to
slay him.
Go into the Roche right now. They cannot give away Aegis on top of Team Liquid. Did you see how brutal that push was? Sure, it was a slow push. Team Liquid now working on the Aegis. This one will come with Aegis and Cheese.
IG want to fight it, Matu taking it down fast. The Roche about to fall. Indeed it will. Blasting success up to the high ground. He's forced to retreat. Bringing through the trees with a double damage rune and a freshly completed Desolator. Miracle could be a huge damage dealer in this fight. He does drop down into a camp while the flank takes four. Matumba Man coming in first. The TP onto the wolves, and now blinking into position. Miracle trying to bring down Q early. Locked up the chain front. It's a bouncing beautifully. Massive damage from the Lich. And now Miracle standing his ground, fighting out that Lycan. The Wukong's command will end. The pain might begin now. Matu on the run, very low, but has the Aegis. Second life also for mind control with the cheese. Can they win round two? It doesn't seem like it. The follow up now begins, but the kiting XXS still alive, burrowing onto the Ursa. Bear being dealt with for now. OP low, not dead just yet. G8 salvaging, they get three. Liquid prevail. But they had to spend a lot there, Lumi. They blew the Aegis, they blew the cheese, they did it outside the base. So they won't be able to threaten high ground with their full complement. At the same time, there's no out buyback
center
here.
Coming in from the back line
for him, and now the Epi onto Matu from the rear. They get the Ursa. That might force Mind Control back. The wheels might have just come off of this push. Mind Control slow to retreat, but the caustic is going to make this a bit trickier.
I don't think they can win that fight. They're going to try. It's going to be close here as Mind Control.
Purge, hit him from the front. Oh. Boboka with the tricks, looking for the clean trade, and
it's
now picking
it. Back. I don't know if you want to go in. There's some
going on. Oh, they do.
Finally.
IG. Caustic it's
burn.
A spiky mouthful.
I don't know about
commitment.
This, man.
Still the commitment. Still the commitment.
Oh, here comes Monkey King. Get out. Get out. You're not going to get the kill. Ice Blast comes in. Boboka gets strike. Jim hits the deck. And now Monkey King jumps forward.
IG getting sloppy, getting desperate. Liquid able to take advantage. The sun also rises as this melee rax drops lower and lower. Liquid will take it. One lane now opened up. Range to fall as well. Upper
right
bracket
now?
Lives on the line. Liquid are doing it, working on the melee rex. IG
wrap
must
around.
Respond, and they
wrap
must
around.
Do it soon. They look for the flag. XXS revving up the Epi,
they
but
see
what's
him.
He gonna hit?
They see him.
A swing, a miss. He gets nothing. Now Liquid chasing forward, IG racing in. They want to kill that keeper, but GH elusive. They finally get onto him, isolating him in the trees. Goes for the TP out. Where's the stuns? There are none. Away he goes, but still this does leave Matumbo Man stranded. The Ursa, in a bit too far, is going to fall. Now the Bristleback, being overwhelmed, slowing him down with the Shivas. Miracle has to watch him as he slowly gets chipped away at. He's in the trees, hiding for what he can. Still GH back into the fray, keeping his team alive. Overextending perhaps, Boboka could be punished. A staggered retreat, but IG aren't ready to give up the chase just yet.
Because
they keep on pushing forward. They want more. Buyback again. Ursa looking for the punish. He gets the kill. The Riki's down. And Lumi, that's a dieback. No smoke cloud for this fight. Liquid are very close. That melee Rex, a bit over half HP. Can they hold the line?
Lycan shapeshift down for 25 seconds. I think without the shapeshift and the Riki, they have no way to stick on GH. GH is the most important hero right now. In fact, it's going to be Raiden jumping in. They want the Sand King. Ice Blast coming in, and they bounce it back in. GH with the L-Use play. Team Liquid going on the Raxus, and you're right, LD. They are doing it. Another set of Raxus. Miracle, man fighting up against OP.
Commitment from Mind Control. It's all about that melee. Slowly, but surely, the mace does its work. One more swing. Down it goes. Two lanes for Liquid. They are hanging on, keeping the upper bracket dream alive. Now back to the Sand King. They need the third lane. IG are scrappy. They won't give up easy. But Liquid have the creep advantage now. Two lane shoving in. It's a three-pronged assault. They keep the push going. Now the tower falls, one last lane remains. That's all that stands between Liquid and a game three. Effigy's biting the dust, and now the fight breaking out. But Tumble Man control, but he gets off the enrage. He tanks through it all. The Chain Frost bouncing. Ooh. Beautiful stuff from the carry Lich as Q keeps his team in the game.
Go for GH.
Being chased. They're gonna bring him down. IG not out of this yet. Pounding into the Ursa. He tries to fight it out, but the ice armor's there. The evasion is as well, and he can't get the kill. Three fall for Liquid. Close.
Not done
but
yet.
Not over yet.
Sand King teleports in, finds mind control. You'll set up. Here comes the cavalry. All five still alive for IG. They isolate him.
Barrett
they bring
home.
Him down.
Wants to help. He's waiting in position. Can mind control possibly get out of here? The quills are stacking up. He's slow.
There's
he
no
gets
way.
Hit from the front. He will fall.
Down.
All right.
IG.
Now. Damage
oh, man.
Control. Damage
what
control.
A hole they are in now.
He also makes buyback super crucial. Ursa bought back during that middle team fight, and he was able to get recalled in instantly. You kill GH, and you have a chance.
Yeah, they are definitely identifying him as public enemy number one, IG.
Run him down,
chasing
man.
Him out. There's the Glimmer. He's got the Ghost Scepter as well. The Wukong's command drop. Saving Private GH is the call. But in goes OP. Diving deeper for this. He turns back for Kuro. The rest of the team takes the Keeper down. He's got the buyback. Kuro does not. And pouncing away, Miracle retreats to the confines of high ground. The base slowly being chipped from north and south.
Okay, they're going to keep pushing.
They yes. are killing out the buffer buildings, though.
That's true.
IG still trying to force the issue here. Miracle looking to slow them down in XXS with the pursuit. No dukes from you, Miracle, they say. The stuns get lobbed in. The blink forward. IG not out of it yet. Kill after kill coming their way. Towers are falling. Liquid perhaps feeling a bit overconfident.
IG
love challenging. They rotate around XXS with an arcane rune, so the low cooldown stun in play in this fight.
Where's GH?
Finds GH. Oh, almost, almost. There you go. Burrows in, still clips him, and now the connection is Bapoka surges forward. GH stays alive. The Glimmer cape enough to keep him a buddy shape, but Bernie now and nipping at his heels. Ghost Scepter doing what it can. Finally, they will slay the beast. He instantly buys back. They know how crucial this keeper is. They know they can't afford to give up this Roche. Liquid are committing for it, and now it's the Sand King they want, the Sand King they might get. Burrows away, looks for the save with the Lotus Orb coming through. Will it be enough? They'd rather sack the Riki, but that is a gem down.
In fact, I don't think there are any gems available for IG, whether it's on their heroes or in their shop. And we are still in the same situation where IG is down by two set of racks.
Somebody wants that cheese, surely.
Okay.
Now Lumi, if he dies in this push, that could be a big problem. Because we've seen how important he is to their team fight. Liquid are smoking in. They're just looking to dive an early assault on this melee Rex, perhaps finding kills to start it off.
No
Let's
bash.
See. The jump comes through, but the Sand King there with the kite.
Bashing
off the
bash.
Yules. XXS, he burrows back to safety. Liquid have gone really deep for this kill. Ice Blast streaming into the fountain.
Dodge that Ice Blast. Bang, he's gone. Sand King out for 100 seconds.
That might be it. Liquid just got to push these lanes in, but look at the waves. They're being cut by the Alk. Illusions denying these creeps. Buying time, but creeps are coming top. Mind control. Thwack. Thwack. Black continues to work. Miracle at his side.
Bobuka going in on the backline. He's going for the kill on Kuroki. Kuroki force that back out. He's jumping back in. He wants Kuroki. Miracle comes in though. They get Bobuka. Chain Frost will finish the job of 1-for-1 trade.
IG are down both supports now. That AA has buyback. OP now comes in one at a time into the meat grinder. Commitment here, but that Bristle stays alive. Very tanky. They keep on nipping at his heels, but can they bring him down?
Drop
OP diving him. Now Matu looking to bail out his buddy with the turnaround. Liquid once more under the breach, and they have done it. Game three awaits.
LD, you want a crazy statistic?
Sure.
IG was leading in gold the entire game.
We have an Ember Spirit, a signature hero for Miracle.
Oh, wow. That's tough. I wonder if Ember Spirit will go mid.
In that situation, it might be a possible kill if there's a follow-up stun or silence. The bottom lane is probably the slight surprise here, or this Earthshaker. Yeah, we have seen this in the 1v1
oh, he
mid,
might
but,
die here, though.
Oh, this could be the real first blood. Chance to start. Follow-up from Kuro. Crush comes through, and
Well, gets off a great fissure, but great ain't going to get the job done. Miracle drawing the first blood, and meanwhile in the mid lane, Boboka having a fish again with the roll, but Matumba Man deftly dodges it.
Yeah, the saves are going to be mostly coming in from the hero's innate abilities, using the time walk to run away or just fire Remnant out.
And itemizing defensively, but OP gets caught out here. Cold Feet not going to tick in. Able to just walk away.
Tower.
Kuro tanking the tower. They'll need to juggle this aggro. Boboka looking for the punish, then they wrangle him back. Ice Cream is a nice afternoon treat here for
IG. The bear too.
A bear kill as well. Charging in.
Delta
he whips the stun. Uh-oh.
All right.
No way to punish this. The glimpse on cooldown, a very long cooldown at these early first few levels. But look at the money shrine. IG are going to be enjoying this regen. All the while, Burning is farming. IG look to make their move. The Echo Slam commitment bottom. XXS finds the solo kill on GH. Again, Ancients were stacked. They've been a bit of a point of contention as Liquid dropped an Observer Ward down previously to try and keep chats on them. Did get dewarded.
Top lane, they're going to go for Kurogi. There is the backstab coming in for Boboka. They have Glimpse available as well. They will cast it.
There is a Chrono, though. Does Mind Control want to take this fight? There's no backup coming. At least for now, it seems they'll get that clean kill. Now Mind Control walks away. Another death. These supports are starting to stack them up.
And
they might lose more. The silence is
Kick.
There.
One more.
Finish it? Oh. Mind Control walking away at the final moment. And in the mid lane, the dive onto OP. Remnant commitment. Miracle making his own rotation. So a core finally going down now. A big kill for Liquid. And
That's
they've been
crazy.
Yanking him. Yep. XXS is crushing this game right now.
Remember, LD, the way that he played last game, at least for the first half, he was just stalking.
Mind Control might be caught out here. Big catch for Liquid, looking for the bashes. Now the
nice,
bubble deployed.
Chrono.
Huge commitment, allowing GH to hit him. I don't know if it's
He's still alive, though.
Burning
okay,
with the Warcry, finally.
Good bash.
Go down.
It was very important for Mind Control to get those bashes in because the Warcry was out and a lot of the physical damage is mitigated.
XXS could...
Yeah, he needs a plus one.
Open this game up.
He's
got the Echo ready. Mind Control does have raindrops, but I think with a plus one, like you said, he's killable. But meanwhile, bottom lane Q in danger, brought down. They're going to look for the trade top. Mind Control, any second, starting with the fissure. They want to save that Echo Slam if possible with the silence coming through. No, they have to commit it, and they will score the kill. Don't have the burst with those raindrops to save it, but definitely worth it here. The one opportunity mid, but they didn't have the vision.
Right.
Now Liquid smoking up, Mind Control moving
Chrono Ice
to the
Blast.
East and looking for the jump. Miracle can start the party, get off the chains of Burning, Remnant forward, commitment from him, Q is there. Welcome
fast.
To the Thunderdome,
so
Liquid! Oh, those reactions! A thing of beauty as they go down to make it three with GH going home. Absolute masterpiece of an ambush. You called it, Lumi. Q
lightning
is
fast.
Reef. Yeah. Are looking to make a move. I'm not sure if this Burning Blink has been scouted, but in any case, they have that good long-range initiation. Mind Control in danger now. Could be caught out. Who's going to jump first? Oh, rolling forward. Boboka trying to scout, but they don't have the vision. They still get up the silence, and now smashing him through with the Static Storm. Laguna raining in the pain. They get the kill.
Just like how GH was public enemy number one last game, the shift has...
Now mid, Echo, Fissure, see ya, Miracle!
Solo.
XXS, what a performance it has been. XXS marching in again under cover of smoke. IG could be caught off guard because Liquid are coming from the rear. Up the ramp, Miracle gonna break that smoke, but already the trap's been sprung. They lock onto Matumba Man, they commit heavily, dumping damage in, but Mind Control is there, trying to save the day, doesn't matter. Magnetize will finish him off, and now he's on the run, surging forward. Miracle tries to get the damage out, but still this Void stays alive on the other side of the fight. Kuroki manages to get a double kill, finishes off lane supports, the chaotic fight, favoring Liquid. Make it three for them, but now the spell looks to get in. The crush is timely, Kuro's in trouble, being kited, XXS, puts a dagger through the heart of Liquid, finds that crucial kill. The totems are coming. Burning, if he has mana for a stun, it could be more. Miracle on the run.
They don't have a stun anymore on Sven. Yeah, it's not a mana.
That'll be it.
Yeah,
so,
the fight's over.
Setting up behind OP to protect him. It looks like IG, the creeps, will likely take this tower down. Burning blinking in. Three slices, down it goes.
They see Miracle top, they want it.
Echo.
Blink, Echo Slam.
Fissure. Where's the Chrono? Mind Control's there, he catches them, but too late. Miracle's down, and now GH gets zapped.
Oh, this is not good for Mind Control. Meet the Cleaver. Burning makes it three.
Looks like Matumba Man was able to run down Q on the bear. There's nothing much that the Disruptor could defend himself.
Kind of late Mask of Madness after the Radiance Mike.
Interesting.
On the bear. Is this a tell that Liquid feel like pressured right now to...
Well, hold on, thought it's going to be the initiation again. The Chain Stun's going to be there, and IG just dominates them.
Crushed. And now GH whipping his own crush. Liquid getting forced back. Now, they did commit the BKB. Do they still want to fight? They're playing it very patiently. XXS now Shadow Blade complete. A second one, as mentioned by the panel, likely to be the case, is being built. OP halfway there, and now the Glimpse. They're going to catch up Matumba Man. This is a fight Liquid must take. The Void's got
Savage Roy,
a respawn soon, but doesn't matter. XXS already gets the job done. He will pay with his life, ending an unstoppable streak, but he just spent his gold, got that Shadow Blade, got the crucial lone Druid kill.
Yeah, it's really a tough spot.
It's a rock and a hard place. Like, yeah. I don't think the BKB would be bad necessarily, but I can also understand where it's not the most appealing item. Here comes the smoke. OP out in front. They're going to make their move.
They stun him! They just stun him!
Mind Control! What an anticipation play! Oh, that hurts. Now GH on the run. Magnetized bringing him low. He goes down. Miracle next. Pulled back in. Zippity doo-dah. See you later. But now IG, they can turn their attention towards this tower, and XXS, he's on non. Echo,
okay.
Get the totem again! IG, they're not just getting the one kill Lumi, they're getting the follow-ups! They are running roughshod over Liquid.
By that random LSA, you say prediction, but I think he's just one of the attack speed, man.
In any case, it hurts. That is for damn sure. Liquid. In the damage and net worth department, Burning's now completed a Crystallis, grabs the Hyperstone. Daedalus not too far off after that for him, and again, an aggressive foray into the Liquid territory. They might catch one. Matu is there. The hits just keep on coming. Liquid are starting to crumble on the big stage.
So much burst damage that by the time that the Void could react, likely your players are already dead. You know, when you have Laguna Blade, when you have Burning coming up with big
crits. They might find one. Disruptor caught out. Q is there. The follow-up Chrono gets that Earth Spirit, but do they want to go? No, actually! He's punished GH! Now might fall. Burning there, looking for the cleanup. Three go down! Even when they try the Chrono, it ends up haunting them.
And now Chrono's down. If you're IG, you're like, okay, let's just get an objective. The fact that he's worried about getting killed so much that he's unable to freely go for solo kills of his own. That's generally one of the strength of Ember Spirit. In fact,
OP.
Looks like he's going to get solo killed here again. Do they have enough? Oh boy, you bet they do.
IG making it look easy.
Jayo.
Cheering themselves on, and somewhere ROTK likely smiling for his old friend Burning. They have a BOTs on the Lina.
Oh, yeah, they could.
Like, they have mobility to hunt that bear.
Yeah.
And they have multiple heroes who can kill it or at least force it away. But here comes Liquid on the smoke. Burning would be a huge catch, but the smoke breaks uphill. Burning gets away. He's still got the BKB ready. Do they commit? Liquid, no, this is a bad idea. Back over there. Now the Yule Scepter trying to buy time. One stun, and he is done for. Chewing through him with the sword. Now the Echo
Slam.
The follow-up's there. XXS again delivers, and now onto a Matumba Man. Mind Control in. Mind Control dead. No solutions. No hope. Glimpse on back. Make it four. Invictus Gaming absolutely slaughtering Liquid. Curl likely the last man down. Make it five. IG on the cusp, on the verge of top six.
That's never really a good position to be in, especially on the last game of the best of three series, but they are that far behind. However, if IG does commit a huge blunder,
let's Echo, say, oh, he does it again.
All right, well, there's no mistakes to be had for IG. Like
11-2-8 in the offlane against the duel against
they got
the Trilane. They need that Void. He doesn't have buyback. Burning is chewing through Liquid. And more damage piles up. Now the bear, Panda down. They're already endangered. Burning, have mercy. But Boca says no mercy for you. This is our game for the taking. That happened indeed, and slicing forward carves up the AA. Four dead again. Invictus Gaming prevailing here in a way they haven't at TI in a long, long time. Still a ways to go, but Liquid are about to be sent packing to the lower bracket.
What an upset. Team Liquid, the team that a lot of people thought would win the whole tournament, they chose IG as their opponent for this winner bracket, and IG just coming in strong.
Liquid need a miracle, and I don't mean the player. I mean the hero moment. Like, I don't even know what that would be, Lumi. Just wait for this next wave. You know they're gonna come swinging.
Yep.
XXS.
Notice how they don't jump in. Notice how when the creep wave dies, they back off. There's just
patient,
super methodical.
And now, potentially decisive. Birdie does get stunned up. He's still got the BKB. The bear works on him, but the bear gets stunned, controlled. OP pumping in the damage, pummeling it.
This is what happened
again.
This is what happens when you jump in. All they have to do is hit the building.
Now the Chrono's there. But XXS! The god! He somehow interrupts it again, forcing Liquid on their heels. Not even bothering for the buildings. IG are giving the business to Liquid now. They do force them back, but everybody's healthy. They need more damage. Where's it gonna come from? If Bernie never gets a hit, that's all she wrote for Liquid. Miracle stun once, dead for sure.
Ice Blast.
That's the buyback. Ice Blast is there. They do get one. That's a punch, don't deny it. They don't even get the kill. Buyback
crit.
Again. All five dead, and they're still trying to fight. Liquid are down. They're now a corpse that's being punched, kicked, and about to be put 6 feet under. IG have the buybacks if they need them. They've got the damage. They've got the control. The position is theirs. The game is theirs. The series is theirs. And top six is theirs.
Wow. Burning one step closer to that. Oh, there's a pause. One step closer to that TI champion that he so deserves as a player.
I don't know if anyone has been looking for that championship longer. It's a very short list, but IG, they're not there yet. A fantastic showing. Liquid, not quite a match for them, but we have seen this team can be scrappy, and they still have the lower bracket where they can look to bounce back.
The most impressive thing for me, again, is